we briefly said that there's something called the nine palaces. Chinese love numbers, like they'll have a group of something. The nine palaces, the five elements, the four directions, the eight winds. So there's nine palaces. So all that means is you really won't feel balanced in your life unless you're thinking about these nine things, and that is your purpose or your career. So you're maybe not launching in that area, but maybe you're thinking about it. Maybe who's a senior?
Any seniors?
Yeah, so okay. You're really thinking about this, right? Right now you're like all career focused, right? So you right now have to spend a lot of attention, maybe more than some of the other palaces, to figure out what the hell am I gonna do after I graduate? Sorry, what am I gonna do? So, Nick just graduated not that long ago, and now he's moving into a really good career, and it took him a while to figure that out. So he's working for us now, it's really exciting. So anyway,
but. So first is career. So if you're a student right now, that could be your career. That's what you focus on. That's your kind of like your part-time job or full-time job. But if you're about to graduate, then it's really the career is front and center. So that's the first palace. The second palace is relationship.
Relationship. And so this is an important part of your life. Like, you know, you can't really ignore it. You have friends. We are social people, whether we feel social or not. You might be like, oh, I'd rather be by myself. But, you know, in the old days, like ancient times, if you were by yourself, it pretty much meant you were going to die. Like if you were thrown out into the woods, like excommunicated, that was it. The lions would come eat you. You were done, right? So yes, you can kind of live on a cabin in a mountain, but for the most part, we need people and we want a partnership. We want someone special. So it's all about love and relationships. So that's another palace. You need to think about it. And the next one is your health. Okay, so these are the main ones, the first three. Your health is really important to you. And we're gonna talk about the five elements. If you're the wood element, you're already doing a great job on your health. So who thinks they're doing a great job maintaining their health?
Eating healthy, sleeping,
exercising,
moving.
Eating, sleeping.
Ready? Well, you're all in the right place then.
Wow, you're in the right place.
You're all in the right place then. We're gonna work on that.
All right, so the health palace is just not if you're sick so much. Obviously, if you're sick, you're thinking about health, right? Everyone who's sick thinks about being healthy. But if you're doing okay, it's like, are you drinking enough water? Do you think you're eating well? Do you think you're moving your body well? That's the health palace. So do you need to attend to that? Some of us, it's harder. Like I just said yesterday on the podcast, I said, we came here yesterday, by the way. We thought it was yesterday, and I was the one who showed up with no water. I didn't bring a water bottle, and Jay is wood, so she brought one for me and for her. So she's thinking about these things, and some of us need to work on it. It's hard. And then the next palace is wealth. So, you know, as you get older and you're off on your career, wealth is a huge thing. How many times a day do you think about money?
Do you make a decision do you make
based
about money?
On money?
You know, do I have enough or I don't have any?
Right?
Yeah.
So if we gave you $10 million right now, what would you do?
There you
do?
Go, travel. She just said, just travel.
Yeah.
What would you do?
No, seriously,
how would your life
think
change?
About it.
If
what
you
would
didn't
you
have
do?
To worry about
what
money,
what would you do with $10 million?
What would you do if you didn't have to worry about money? How would your life change? Would you stay in school?
Yeah.
Okay, would you
would you, I just
would you
at
stay
you.
In school?
I said, what would you do with $10 million? There you go. So you're focused on wealth. That's the first thing you thought of. So wealth is really important to you, okay?
She said
what's
travel.
What's another answer? Travel.
So that's a palace.
That's one of the palaces. So this person travel, this person well. Someone have a different one? What would you do with your
you
$10 million?
What would you do if you had $10 million and you didn't have to, you could decide whatever you wanted to do. You want to be like Beyonce? Do you want to be like Serena Williams? Like, what would you pick? What would you want to do?
I think I'd buy things for my other family.
Okay, relationship.
And family.
Family.
So
that's right.
One
fire.
That's about
I mean,
that.
Earth. All anyone
right.
else want to contribute really quick? What would you do? How about you? What would you do with $10 million? Pay off school loans.
Pay
okay.
off school loans. Wealth. Okay. What would you?
Yeah, you invest it so that
like,
you invest it or put it in the bank so that like it's
grow it.
Okay.
Ooh,
more
smart
money.
Woman.
But would you live right now, or you would just keep waiting?
Yeah, Jackie.
When's enough? When's enough?
Yeah,
what? When's
You don't have to put $10,000 or $10 million in the bank and pay off your student loans.
Pay student loans.
You invest some of it, you put some of it in the bank.
There you go.
Okay.
All right. So she's, so that's a wealth palace.
That's definitely a wealth
idea.
Yes.
Okay. So let's move on. The next palace is home. Home. Okay. So now maybe you're living in a dorm or a sorority house or something like that. But home is going to be really important to you soon, right? Because soon you're not at UMass anymore, and you have to actually make a home. Like, this is something you have to think about, right? I'm working with someone who went to UMass and now has to buy her first apartment. And it's like, what do I want it to look like? What do I want it to feel like? It's a big decision, right?
And would it look like the house or the home that you grew up in? Or would it be like completely the opposite? Like, I am never going to have it like that. I want to do it like this.
Yeah, so do you like decorating? Do you want to have lots of people over? Do you want it to be social? Do you want to be that cabin on the hill where nobody comes to? I mean, this is all about you, right? And then, and home represents also like a spiritual home, maybe your family, maybe church or some kind of organization that you want to be a part of. So it's bigger, than just
even
your house.
Even right now, sorority, that's
yeah,
your family,
sorority,
right?
Yeah, sorority is your home.
Yeah.
So you already have a home. You have a family, a community. Okay, and the next one is travel. Who's our travel person?
Travel adventure.
And you might think that travel's not that important, an adventure, but even if you don't want to travel across the world and you want to save your money, what about like day travel? You know, what's adventurous in your life? If you're bored and you're never having any fun,
or you just do the same things over and over and over. Do you have a diverse group of friends? Do you eat the same foods all the time? You know, do you freak out if you turn the wrong way? And you still can see where you're going. Like, it's adventure. It's a sense of adventure. It's a sense of travel. And then I always like to say the overriding travel is that anywhere you go in the world, people are fundamentally the same. They're kind, they're loving, they're not what the media makes them out to be, scary and bad. So you know in your heart that everyone is the same wherever you travel.
After college, I went to the Peace Corps, and I was in West Africa, and I remember this day I was walking. I decided to walk in the middle of the desert, literally sand dunes, right? Just sand dune after sand dune. And I was so shocked and amazed, because after a few minutes walking, I noticed this little dot on the horizon, and then I noticed it was going like this, and it was going like this, and then I saw, oh, it's a girl, and she's going like this. So I start walking towards her, and I get there, and it's a tent in the middle of the desert, just a tent. It's not like a canvas tent, like a date palms, you know, structure. And she's like, come have tea, come eat dinner with us, stay the night, come stay with us, let's, you know. And I was like, wow, that's like a travel experience that affected me the rest of my life, that someone would be so friendly and so hospitable in the middle of nowhere. I barely knew any Arabic, so I was like, you know, barely conversing with them, and it was pretty powerful. So that's travel.
So think about it. What if you saw it was a person and you got scared, and you're like, oh, I'm going to just go turn the other way, or I'm not going to go, or they said, come in, and you're like, no, they're going to rob me, or they're going to hurt me, and you don't go in. So when you get through with that palace and you know that they're friendly and they're kind and they had a great time, so that's, and you can kind of put that into your life in perspective as you travel, go out and travel in the world. Yeah. I mean, you have to use common sense, okay? Don't be like, woo, you know, that gun is not really for me. No, but you know, have in mind that, you know, people are generally kind and loving and open. So,
yeah.
But use your common sense, but have that awareness that people are the same all over the world.
Now, the next palace you might not be thinking about right now, or maybe a couple of you are already deciding, I'm going to have children. That's going to happen in my life. And so the next palace is children. But for those of you who are not thinking about having children, it's also your creativity. It's your creative projects. So you probably have some of those. Like, does anyone take art?
Any art?
Or music?
Crafting, like scrapbooking.
Do you like crafting?
Or writing? Or anything?
How about writing? Any writers?
Any writers? No writers?
What are you guys majoring in? Business? All of you in business?
All in business?
Writers?
I would like to know all your majors as we go along, too. So,
yeah.
Okay, let's just take business. All right, so we talk fast and we talk over each other, but let's just take business. How you look at a proposal or a plan is creatively. How do you do it differently than someone else? It's your creativity. If you said, you know, I love keynote presentations, that is my thing. I am the keynote person for all the presentations. That could, you know, kind of be in that creativity category.
Wait, you're graduating. What's your major?
Operations.
Operations, okay.
So what do you want to do? What's your dream job?
What?
What's your dream job?
CEO.
CEO?
CEO.
So you have a little creativity, right? You have to have a little creativity on how things are going to hold.
Yep.
So the CEO holds the big vision. That would be very good if you would. If you have the wood energy as we go through the day, we'll talk about
that. We'll get to that. All right, so the next one is wisdom. So this is one that comes sometimes later in life because you're doing knowledge right now, which goes with career. So you're stuffing your heads with lots of things, right? And you're learning. But then eventually you start applying that in the world and you gain wisdom from experience. So as you grow older, that's going to become more important. We say that wisdom comes from this idea of 10,000 hours. Have you ever heard of that idea before? There's a book called Outliers that talks about when you do 10,000 hours of something, you basically become wise. So you're almost probably at 10,000 hours of being a student if you're a senior. So, but you know, that's your wisdom of, I know how to be a student now. And the first year students, they don't know anything, right? Seniors, like first year students, they don't know anything, right? So you're wise,
So if a first year came to you and asked you something, you'd be able to tell them, like, because you've done it. That's your wisdom.
That's your wisdom. Okay, and then the last palace is the hardest palace in some ways. It's called prosperity. And prosperity is, okay, so you told us all these great ideas for putting away the $10 million. Did anyone actually think about giving away some of that $10 million?
Anybody think, oh, I want to help a charity?
Okay,
or
what did you think?
FTK.
Ah, okay.
Okay.
Anyone else want to give some of their $10 million away?
She said family a little bit over
there.
Yeah,
family.
Some
all right.
Stuff.
So that's your prosperity. And so that is definitely one of the palaces that sometimes takes wisdom to get to. So maybe as you move through life, you think, oh, I really want to help this person. And it's about having more than enough. The reason we picked $10 million is used to be $1 million was enough money. But now $1 million, you're poor, according to the rich people of the world. Yeah. You need $10 million to feel like you have enough, or more than enough. It's kind of sad. But anyway, that's sort of why we picked that number, because it's kind of a number you think, yeah, I could live the rest of my life on that and not have to worry. I have more than enough money. So that's your prosperity when you start thinking about, what am I going to do with that? That's not just about me.
And it can also be resources. It could be fuel. It could be food. It could be all different. Time is a resource. So you could give time away. Say you had an afternoon and someone really needed your help. They needed you to walk the dog or take care of a kid or some other thing. And you had that time and you freely gave it without asking for money or anything back. That would be a prosperity moment.
And who knows, you might make another $10 million or $20 million because she wisely invested, and then you might start a nonprofit, right, with 10 of it, and say, oh, I'm going to give to the children or do something like that. So.